Mr. President, Amanda Shear.
Well, Amanda, hello.
Hey, Mr. President.
How are you? It's good to see you.
And her parents are here too.
Congratulations, Amanda.
Thank you.
Would you propose?
Roberta and Lloyd Shear.
Hello. Oh, Mr. President. Should we have a family picture?
Sure.
Nice.
Mr. President, Officer Richard Nugent, the Director of.
Hello, good to see you again.
And Paul Conan.
Yes, hello.
His wife, Pat Conan.
Hello.
And Dr. Kip Penn.
Hello.
Amanda.
I'm a Vegas fan from our state.
Well, thank you very much.
Would you like to hold that over so you can see it?
Yes.
This is the front.
And it indicates that Wisconsin is the dairy state. Well, thank you very much. And I guess the same thing on this one.
This one doesn't really matter though.
Well, thank you very much. Well, I just have a few little items here too. Now, inside here is a engraved jar with a seal on it, and it's filled with jelly beans. And just in case, I want you to open it before you get home or something. That's a little sample of what's in the jar. And these are bookmarks as little souvenirs here.
Thank you. Thank you.
Key ring, souvenirs, the gentleman. And one.
On the.
Oh, there.
Staff over here. Thank you, Mr. President. Could we have a group picture?
No, you can't get locked out of your car.
Can I get a group shot?
Well, Amanda.
Group shot.
It's good to see you. You're doing a very wonderful thing here. Now, I don't want to play it. Character in a motion picture who was a had been a very religious human being. He too had a class, but he became one of the greatest baseball pitchers of all time in the major leagues, and I played his life story in a movie. Anything that can stop you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. I want you for what you're doing.
You.
Mr. President, this is Ralph Hamm.
Yes, hello there.
Great to see you.
Well, this is. We'll put you into doubling in brass there for a while, but thank you for the job you did on the. And for doing it on the small.
It was my pleasure. It really was a great group. And I couldn't find more supporters of the administration than the delegates.
Well.
They were very supportive. I brought you two things. One is you work out, we've been active in privatization, which was a big issue of theirs, and also a paperweight from the conference as a.
Oh. Well, thank you very much. A souvenir for you.
Good.
Thank you. Remember the hard times.
I will.
All right. Well, thanks very much.
Thank you. And as I said, we'll get the recommendations to you probably by the end of November.
Well,
we'll get for the next 2 years a number of those enacted.
Thank you for this.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, Rex. All right. These people were in, some of them were in 24 years ago.
24 years ago.
These four are here today.
Well,
presenting the first book to President Mrs. Kennedy.
Well, my goodness.
What?
Hi.
Yes, okay.
see you.
See you.
Mr. President, good to see you.
Oh, good to see you.
Mr. President, nice to see you again.
Nice to see you
again. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Keep signing
the ground for it.
Oh, there.
I want to hear the whole thing. Nice to see you.
Mr. President. This is very gracious of you. Dr. Edwards.
Hello. Nice to see you.
You know, Carter.
Hi.
Mr. President?
Hi,
in a different capacity?
Yes. No questions.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you. Just an appreciation on this occasion of this 25th anniversary certificate of appreciation for all that you've done. Very pleased to present this to you now.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. President.
And to thank you and thank all of you here for all that you have done.
I accept this for the board, and I express this opportunity for your fine cooperation giving our book such a wonderful send-off a short time ago. It's already bearing fruit.
Well,
good. Thank you so much.
Good. Now, before you leave, here, just some souvenirs for all of you here. These are key to buying.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We've got it right.
It's not a group shot.
We're coming right on the budget.
We can.
Yeah, once a year. We're going to do a group photo. I did. I had 18. We're going to do a group photo.
And I said, why? He gave me quite a lesson. He said, well, no one ever reads the entire caption under a picture. They always start reading.
Association to you and the First Family.
Well, thank you. And as National Youth Ambassador for the American Lung Association, Allison and I, we travel around the country and go to as many schools as we can, as many states as we can, to speak to our peers and spread the word about this work.
Well, I think that's great.
Thank you. It's a very important thing.
Yeah, a very wonderful thing for you.
Oh, and here is a nice large frame.
Wonderful cause.
Okay.
Know a little bit about it, but back in California, Nancy was the state chairman.
She was.
This is a state chairman? I guess it's a national state.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a mini.
Mr. President, we also have some people from the American Lung Association. Dr. Lois Ellison.
Hi, Lois Ellison.
Richard Giacchetti. Francis DeMille.
Hello,
and George Weiler.
Glad to see you again.
Very nice. Well, thank you very much. Now, we all get a picture here. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
And now, I just have a presentation here. The
Dr. Ellison.
I guess I was going to say that. Might as well start.
Thank you.
Mr. President, I have a picture of you here in 1946 of you receiving a similar.
That's you.
I think it's 1960.
1967.
Well, thank you very
much.
Mrs.
Reagan would probably like to have those.
Yes, yes.
These are also for Mrs. Beebe.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Well, wonderful work. And I, particularly now, on my mind is that you're emphasizing also so evident now that the tragedy just comes from that.
Yes.
It's almost like Nancy's campaign on drugs.
That's exactly what we said.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Harper? Oops, say this. Look at it. Yes, hello. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you also.
Washington.
Oh yes, we've seen quite a bit.
Why don't you come over here and why don't we get a group picture?
We're trying to talk.
Want you to.
We're trying to talk. Neil and Beth and my dad into coming. But
okay, if everyone can look right here for one shot. Thank you, sir.
Well, couldn't talk anymore.
No, we couldn't talk anyone into coming at this point in time.
Is this your first trip to Washington?
Actually, we've been here, I was here 2 years ago.
Oh. Scott's been here 3 times.
Yeah, McDougal's, this is his first time.
Well, this some souvenirs of this visit. A bookmark with the seal.
Oh, thank you. Well, he would like to ask you.
Right. We'll ask it. I was wondering, do you watch The Wheel of Fortune? Because The Wheel of Fortune, I know your brother.
He's wondering if you ever watched
it. It's a standing joke around on our end. The Wheel of Fortune on the television.
I very seldom. I've glanced at it in passing or something, but never really just watched it. And I know I shouldn't have because everybody talks about it.
Vanna White.
But there are a lot of things like that I don't have much time for. Like going to football games, which you can't do.
I was wondering, I have a match collection. If you have a pack of matches with the presidential
You must have, except that since I don't smoke, I don't have any. Here with
matches?
Yeah.
Daddy probably has some.
It's going
to be the centerpiece of Well, we'll be watching you. Good luck.
Yes.
Well, there's a lot to straighten out this week. Absolute falsehoods on the air. This big storm they've raised, quoting Danish sailors and so forth.
Is that what it's gotten into now?
Huh?
Is that what it's gotten into now? Also, quoting
Danish.
Yes, and
they showed pictures of a Danish freighter. Oh, yes, they claimed they carried arms and so forth. You know, the things that we have sold to Iran. Right now, because we're trying to establish some contact there for when the Khomeini is gone.
Right, hopefully it will be soon.
Won't be so
well. We've got match gloves. Give you a whole stack of them.
Yes, did you
have some more? I am.
That's really nice.
Don't mind us.
Certainly.
Thank you very
much.
Don't smoke either.
Thank you.
Thank them. Everything that we've sold, you could put in one cargo plan and still have a lot of room left. And that was the talk. And that all of us had to do with defense. It doesn't change the balance. And that's what we would say to them. Kind of pressure, wasn't it? It's far removed, which is why I have a move that we've still got to keep going.
That's right.
Matter.
Unfortunately, just get things and they just keep going with it.
Well, you know, there are a lot of us who are selling arms to Iran in this war.
Oh, much.
See, another one is peaceful settlement between the two countries, which they'll call it off.
be wonderful.
Mr. President, we're late. We've got a few more to bring in. I'm sorry. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure to be
here.
Mr. President, good work. Good to see you again, sir.
Good to see you.
Hello, Mr. President.
How do you do? Here is another winner.
That's right.
Well, congratulations, Governor.
Well, thank you, sir. How do we get over here on this picture, mate?
Okay. How do you want this?
You want to get over there, Mr. Carl. I don't want to have my picture on the front cover.
I sure you do. Oh, well, we'll take a separate one. It's just a family picture.
By the way, the help you've been giving me on this, we're starting to make some headway in senior executive service. Fit call today, and they requested that we give them equal publicity on the Government Excellence Award. They're going to give away a bunch.
Good.
Maybe we'll get excellence in government for this after all.
Do you want to get a seated or standing photo now for the cover? President.
Standing.
Standing right here with just the two of them.
Yeah. Sure, I get this thing open.
This is your current photo.
Right, yeah.
Never find it.
Carl.
Yeah.
So too.
That's good.
Thank you. Wow. They left the room. Reality had never been hit with so many high-level people with a single message before in their life.
Well, you know, I was very self-conscious, not knowing what all the rest of you had said to them. I was wondering if there was anything left for me to say that they hadn't already heard.
Well, they enjoyed
it. They did. They wanted to hear it from you.
Well, that's right. They'd much rather hear it from you if it's the third time they heard it.
Well, I just had the two young people from television, just juveniles from two television shows are in here this year. They're the ambassadors for the Lung Association Christmas series. And they were telling me that their message, where they're going, of course, they're talking against smoking.
Yeah.
And their message is just say no.
There's one interesting aspect about this program compared to the smoking business. Some of the same people who applauded GSA for putting out that instruction about we were setting aside just limited smoking areas in federal buildings. Some of the same people who applauded that are the ones who were raising hell about the urinalysis testing.
The drug check? Yes. I still think that if somehow we could approach it, for example, like the Professional Athletic Associations, if we'd gotten appealed to them to volunteer to do it.
Yeah.
So I date back in the world of sports to when I was a sports announcer, and when there wasn't a football pro player or baseball pro player who would endorse cigarettes or beer or anything of the kind. They figured they were role models and they wouldn't do it.
Okay.
And now you find them casting votes that they don't want to take a drug test.
We had our lunch and I had Carl Eller and Roy Jefferson there. But I know, being active in the D.C. Police Boys and Girls Club, at least locally, I didn't know Carl Eller, but I did Roy Jefferson. Those kids just follow him around like he's magic. However he behaves, that's the way it is.
Sure. I'm sorry.
Yes. You've
got two.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you again.
Already, I've got people waiting to go.
Hi, Mr. President. Hi. I'd like to meet some friends online. Sue Ellis, Gallaudet University, and Dr. Jerry, who is the president.
Nice to see you. Would you like to come in and have a picture? I think it would be a nice trip to help. All right.
Thank you.
We have one with just my president.
Sure.
With the two presidents.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Just two little souvenirs that I had. A key ring for you.
Well, thank you very much.
And a bookmark for you.
Just
a souvenir of the visit here.
Well, we're very grateful to you. We also want to thank you for signing the bill that conferred universal status on Gallaudet. The America's Lewis University, we appreciate your support.
Pleased to do it, and I'm honored to be signing the diploma.
Thank you. Thank you.
He knows he got that too.
And with your permission, Mr. President, we're going to send you an invitation to visit Gallaudet. Maybe it commences.
Well, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Thanks, President.
Good.
Well, this is an important bill.
Glad you do it on such short notice.
Glad to be here. Okay, it means a lot to me.
Well, hi, Joe.
Mr. President.
I shall get to 1744 here. can get it passed. I know how hard you worked.
Oh, boy, we worked on this one. It's landmark stuff.
Huh?
It's landmark stuff. It's,
well,
it's your best trade bill, by the way.
I got a few things in there that I'm...
You're going to work on those.
I was going to say, I'll be working Congress with them, but I think the good very much outweighs the...
sure does.
...the bad.
Well, it's like you say, a classic compromise. It's hard to solve every problem, but we do a pretty good job. That's great. Thank you.
There you are.
Thanks, everybody. I tell you, that means a lot more than you know. I appreciate it.
Well, glad to do it.
Great to see you.
Thanks so much.
You take care.
All right.
Enthusiastic about the Attorney General's 7-point program to break the back of the pornography industry in our country, and this is going to be and is a priority of our administration. As you know, you'll be creating an obscenity prosecution task force and law center within the Department of Justice. Each U.S. Attorney's office around the nation will also step up its efforts to prosecute obscenity. We'll be cracking down on international and interstate trafficking in obscenity, and we'll be assisting and training state and local law enforcement agencies in the prosecution of these cases. We'll also be sending to Congress legislation that will make the prosecution of those involved in the production and distribution of obscenity easier, take away the profits of the obscenity industry, and better protect our children from being exploited by the pornography industry. Last week, I signed into law the Child Sexual Abuse and Pornography Act of 1986, so it's now a criminal offense to seek out children to be used in the production of child pornography, as well as to advertise, buy, or sell a child pornography. As I said in 1984 when I signed the Child Protection Act into law, there's no one lower or more vicious than a person who would profit from the abuse of children, whether by using them in pornographic material or by encouraging their sexual abuse by distributing this material. This pornography, I said, is ugly and dangerous, and if we do not move against it to protect our children, then we as a society just aren't worth very much. I don't need to tell you that much has been accomplished. More still remains to be done. Government at all levels, federal, state, and local, has a vital role to play in the war against pornography. Our ultimate success depends upon the commitment of each individual citizen. I'm tremendously encouraged by the commitment and leadership that each of you is showing in organizing this country's religious community, and I'm grateful to know that we can count on your support when we move our legislative package to the Congress next year. But now, that's enough for me. I would like to hear some words from you.
You're dealing with terrorists!